Hi guys, welcome back to the channel for another video. So today I'm going to review the Maruti Suzuki S-Cross that's sitting right behind me, and special thanks to Nexa Jorhat for allowing me to shoot this video. So the showroom details will be given in the description below, and also you can see right now running in the screen. Now moving forward, the S-Cross is a crossover and it's not actually an SUV, and it also happens to be one of my favorite car under 15 lakh rupees. So today I'll be going to give you an in-depth review of the car along with the drive impression. I'll also tell you the good things and the bad things about this car. So this is the top spec alpha variant that comes with all sorts of automatic headlight, rain sensing wiper and those sorts of features. So keep watching video till the end, where I will tell you in details about the car. So without any further delay, let's get started.
Suzuki S-Cross or Maruti Suzuki S-Cross is a crossover from Suzuki, as the name suggests, and it's not a proper SUV. Launched in 2015, the S-Cross was the first car to be sold via Maruti Suzuki's premium outlet Nexa. Initially, it was offered with diesel engine option, but with the BS6 norms coming into effect from 2020, it was facelifted and now offered with a sole 1.5-liter petrol engine with 12-volt mild hybrid tech and gets option for both 5-speed manual and an AMT driving the front wheels. It's offered in 4 trims, Sigma, Delta, Zeta and Alpha, and prices starts at Rs 8.58 lakh for the Sigma manual transmission and goes up to Rs 12.55 lakh for the top spec Alpha with AMT. All prices at showroom Jorhat. The car that I reviewed is the top spec Alpha variant with 5-speed manual and white exterior color. So the S-Cross is offered with many great things in this price point, like all-wheel disc brakes, dual front airbags with ABS and EBD as standard across all trims, leatherette upholstery, auto wipers, auto headlight and even auto climate controls. But it misses out on features like sunroof and rear AC vents, as the car is now a bit outdated. So in this video, I will tell you in details about the S-Cross and also give the drive impression. So keep watching the video till the end. And before starting the main part, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel and press the bell notification icon to never miss any new content. With that said, let's get started.
So like always, starting with the keys, you'll get two keys with the S-Cross. Fairly simple key. One side you can see Suzuki logo, then there are two buttons, lock and unlock button, no button, dedicated button for opening the tailgate, or no button for follow me headlamp, or as such this car doesn't get follow me headlamp function. But yes, this variant is the top spec alpha variant. It comes with automatic LED projector headlights, bi projector headlights, but it doesn't get follow me headlamp because this car is now a little bit outdated. Maruti Suzuki is working on updating this car, so you will get to see that by next year, not very soon. Now coming to the front fascia of the car, this is the front fascia of the car. You can see there are the LED projector headlight along with the DRL, then there is the slotted grill and big Suzuki logo here. This grill somehow looks like kind of the AMG grill, if you have seen any AMG car. So there are little bit of cues, design cues that is borrowed from the AMG, like in the grill and also to the headlight. If you consider it, like see it, compare it with previous generation Mercedes AMG S-Class like cars and all sort of, I won't say it's totally copied, but yeah, the grill totally seems like kind of AMG grill, the slotted pan Americana AMG grill, what I am talking about. So here the headlight gets some chrome treatment here. These are the DRLs. I'll light it up and you can see. So this is the bi-projector LED headlight, and here is the indicator, which is not actually LED, it's halogen, and obviously gets automatic headlight function. Down under there are the halogen fog lights, and there is some chrome garnish here. So there are body cladding that runs across the whole body of the car, as you can see. So this is the Baleno, not talking about that right now. Then there are the 16-inch alloy wheels. So the body cladding, talking about the body cladding across the whole body of the car, there are skid plating across the side skirts, and also protection is given because this car is actually a crossover. And again, coming to the front of the car, so same situation here to the fog light. There is some honeycomb type mesh type thing is given, the design is given, and down under here there are more grill or yeah, split grill setup is there. So this here is to put the license plate and all, and down under there is the skid plating, which is actually fiber, it's not metal. Obviously in this price segment you don't get metal and as such things. Now coming to the side profile of the car, here is the side profile of the car. You can see the car is a bit long, and obviously 16 inch wheels, dual tone diamond alloy wheels. The tire section is 215/60 R16, and the best feature about this car is in this price segment, this is the only car you will get in market right now that comes with all wheel disc brakes. So in terms of like driving and handling and all sorts of braking performance, it's superb in this car. And I've actually driven this car before, and I really like how the car drives out on the road. And the diesel, now it comes with petrol, but when it was used to come with the diesel engine, it was really a hunigan to drive this car. Obviously not fast enough, but the handling and all was really very nice in this car. Now coming to the wheel arches, rounded off wheel arches, which actually looks nice in this car. Then again, side skirts here get skid type material, which is actually plastic or fiber. Then chrome door garnish is given here. These are the body colored mirrors, which are actually placed in the door, not on the A-pillar. The A-pillar is thick, and also there is a quarter glass here, hope you can see. And this actually reduces the blind spot in this car. I will show you that when I will give you the drive impression of the car. The outside rear view mirror are big, and no, these are not auto folding, but electrically foldable, which can be folded from the inside. I will show you once I get inside. Then there are integrated LED side indicators here. So the door handles, both the driver and the passenger side door handle get request sensor. This is actually accessory, the door guard or some garnish, or yeah, it's actually door guard to prevent it from getting hit to other doors or to other cars or walls and all sorts of stuff. So there is a chrome line running across the whole door sills or window sills actually. Then rain guard, these are actually accessories. And here is a roof rail, which is metal, and it's actually functional. And again, the rear wheel arches are also rounded off, which looks nice. The car wheels doesn't look smaller compared to the car, because the car is not that high. Yeah, obviously the height is around slightly more than 1.5 meters, and obviously you can see the disc brakes. So both the front and rear wheels get disc brakes. I've already told you ABS EBD as standard. Now here is the fuel filler cap, which is actually not magnetically holding, but spring mechanism. You have to access it from the driver's side area there. And the fuel tank holds around 48 liters of fuel. And this car comes with the mild hybrid tech, as you can see, mild hybrid tech written here. So this is the same engine that you see in every sort of Maruti cars, like the XL6 or Nexa car, or even the Brezza. So it is a 4-cylinder naturally aspirated petrol 1.5 liter petrol motor that makes 105 horsepower and 138 newton meters of torque, and also comes with that hybrid tech, which gives some regenerative braking, idle start stop system and all. And the fuel economy is around 18 kilometers like average. So with 48 liters of fuel tank, the driving range in this car is awesome, which is more than 800 kilometers, which is enough I guess for anyone like driving a car after full tank. So which is really enough, you won't be able to drive 800 kilometers non-stop, but yeah, someone can, then it's good. That's on the exterior part of the car. Let's now go to the rear. Also there are a quarter glass here to increase the interior visibility. So there is also a quarter glass here. This the window at the rear actually opens only this one, not this part here. And I'll show you the visibility of this car, which is really very good from the interior. You don't feel claustrophobic here. Now coming to the rear of the car, here is the rear section of the car. All LED lighting, not actually all, because this part here is actually LED. I've turned it on, you can see right now. Then here is the reverse gear light, and here is the halogen indicator. So LED halogen combination is there. This part here is LEDs, the C-shaped brake light, these are LED. And here is the halogen indicator, here is the halogen reverse gear light. And obviously there is windshield washer wiper, so LED high stop mount brake light. This is the windshield for the rear wiper, the dispenser for the rear wiper. There is no shark fin antenna in this car because this car is obviously a bit dated. So Nexa stickering done here. The rear windshield also gets defogger type material. The car is a little bit dirty because it's out in the barn, so out in the stockyard, so it's a little bit dirty. And then S-Cross badging, you can see here. Again, smart hybrid badging here. So I've already told you this car gets that smart hybrid tech from Maruti, which is actually a very intelligent system. It's not 48 volt, it's 12 volt. So there is a rumor that the upcoming S-Cross that the Maruti Suzuki will be bringing might get 48 volt hybrid system, but that will be for the European market. I don't think India will get that car because of cost cutting and all those sorts of things. But if it's there, and there is also rumor that S-Cross will be coming with this time with sunroof and also ADAS kind of system and all, so that will really eat up other like C segment SUV market, because this car actually looks great and it also happens to be one of my favorite car. I don't really like how the new Creta and the Seltos looks. I would prefer this if I have to buy a car like in 15 lakh rupees mark. And also it gets all like from the base variant, all four disc brakes, which is a great feature. I love that thing. And coming to the rear, so there are badging, S-Cross badging, and Sol-New Suzuki badging here. Nexa is stickering here. So this is the request sensor you also get for locking and unlocking the rear boot. I will show you the rear boot. And then there is also a chrome garnish here. These are actually accessories, you have to put it by yourself. Then black colored bumper here, two reflectors there, so you can see the departure angle. And obviously I forgot to tell you the dimension and long. The car is 4.3 meters in length and its height is around 1.5 meters height, and the ground clearance is 180 mm. The ground clearance, as you can see, it's 180 mm, which is pretty decent because this is a crossover, so it's pretty decent. And the boot, now coming to the boot, the boot capacity is actually 353 liters. There is a request sensor here for locking the car. Also there is a parking sensor, reverse parking camera neatly placed here. And then four parking sensors for park assist, 1, 2, 3, 4. No front parking sensor, but rear parking sensor along with reverse parking camera is there in this variant. This is the top spec alpha variant. Then two reflectors. Then again down under here is skid plating. No diffuser type element, it's simple skid plating. And obviously there is the exhaust. Then no, it doesn't get independent type suspension, but multi-link type rear suspension obviously. And the sphere wheel is inside this car, but the car boot is really very flush. I will show you. And for opening the rear boot, you have to press a button here, and obviously the car is locked now, so I have the key with me, so I can press this, the car is unlocked. And there is a button here and you can just lift it up. And so you can see two hydraulic struts. The boot space is 353 liters, which is not actually best in segment, but it actually good. You can see how much stuff is put inside here. So these are 3D mats and all those things for this car. This is actually the car is meant for delivery, so yeah, there is stuff here. And the you can see how flush the boot area is. Even though the wheel is not under the car, it's inside the boot, it's flush. So the boot space is a little bit less because it's flush, so it's easy to put in heavy luggage if the boot area here is flushed, or the boot tailgate door sills are flushed. Obviously it doesn't get any chrome type material, but there is actually plastic, which are obviously scratchy type material. But yeah, it's fine considering the price of the car. So the wheel is under here. It's a little bit difficult for me to lift it up because so many accessories are for this car is here. So the spare wheel is under there. No, it's not a full size spare wheel, it's actually steel rim, not alloy wheel, and it's okay I guess. Then there is a hook here. Obviously these are scratchy type material. There is also a light placed here, so you have to switch it on like this, and hope you can see. And there is also a 12 volt socket there. There is a 12 volt socket, so light placed there. This is not LED. This is the rear parcel tab, which doesn't look very flimsy. Obviously two hydraulic struts are there. The rear boot can also be accessed via the rear passenger seat. As you can see, I can lift this up. I'll show it once I go inside. So there is a place here to put your hand. So the tailgate is a little bit tall, so you have to access it or pull it down by putting your hand here. So that's it on the boot space. And obviously the rear seats get 60-40 split type rear seats to increase the boot space. And if you split that, the boot space will increase, and obviously these flush door sills here will help you put on heavy luggage. Said lot about the boot space and all. Let's go inside now. Let's just close it. I don't think it closed nicely, so you have to put a little bit of effort, but obviously it closes softly. So that's on the everything exterior of the car. Let's now go inside and talk in details about the rear seating comfort and all. So for that I will come from this side, because I have some stuff put over that side, and obviously the car is locked. Simple push of a button will open the car. Sorry, yes, now it's unlocked. So the door opens wide enough. I cannot open it because there is a car there. So the window area, you can see it's wide. People won't be claustrophobic here. The car is, the wheelbase of the car is around 2.6 meters, so it's long car, not that short. And as such the doors are also wide, and there is soft touch material here which gets perforated type finish here. So this actually is soft touch. No, this is not soft touch, this is actually hard plastic, but the material is really very nice. It's of premium quality hard plastic, and you get soft touch material around this part here, not in the above part here. So there are two partitions, hope you can see. So this portion here gets soft touch type material, this portion also, the handrest gets soft touch type material. Obviously chrome door handles, but satin finish could have been given, but it's chrome, and satin finishing is done around here, which really looks premium. 1 liter bottle holder is there, no place for other like putting clothes and all those sorts of stuff. There is a speaker placed here. Obviously this rain guard is an accessory, you have to get it as an accessory. And the interior of the car is this, you can see, fully leatherette, all black interior. There is little bit of white touch up in the liner here, headliner here. And now coming to the door sills, the door sills here doesn't get any scuff plating, but scuff plating is up above here, and these are actually LED like glowing type. The Nexa is actually glowing, which is a really very great touch, you won't see in other Maruti Suzuki cars. I hope it's accessory, but if it's given from the factory, then it's really very good. Obviously leather type seats, which feels so good to touch. And again, 60-40 split seats. If I pull it here, you can see 60-40 split seats. So adjustable headrest, and again accessible boot from the passenger's side seat. The seat also gets ISOFIX child seat mounts, like you can see here. Anchorage points are there. Then there is a cup or armrest here with twin cup holders. Also leather type finishing is given here. This is really very well padded, and it's of nice quality. Let's go inside and talk more in details about the headroom and all those sorts of thing and other interior features. So coming to the interior, the seats are really very comfortable. It's very nicely well padded. Obviously leather type seats, adjustable headrests are there, and 3-point type seat belts are there for both the passengers. The middle passenger here doesn't get any 3-point type seat belt. There is a simple seat belt here, and the seating comfort is really very nice. I'm really feeling very comfortable. Obviously leather type material is given in this alpha variant, top spec alpha variant. And then the door also get handles with a hook here, and there is also a handle here with hook here. The driver doesn't get any door side handle. There is a handle there, but there is no hook for the front core passenger type, for the co-passenger seat, sorry. Then again, coming to the headroom, lots of headroom is there. Obviously the roof is slightly slanted towards the back, so people around 6 footers will have little bit of issue with the headroom, but there is lots of knee room in this car. The under thigh support for me is good. My height is around 5'5", so for me it's good. And lots of leg room is also there. Obviously the front seat is pushed really to the extreme rear position, so you can see a little bit of less knee room and leg room, but the leg room is actually good. If people can adjust, then it's good for the rear passengers. Obviously scooped out rear seats, as you can see there is also a pocket here, again leather type material, which really feels nice, really very good to touch. No rear AC vents, because this car again is actually outfitted. And again there is armrest for the front driver and co-driver. So I'll show it when I go inside. Then to this a door again, there is that satin finish speaker and obviously chrome door handle and all those sorts of stuff. There's also a quarter glass here to make the cabin feel with light and also make it feel airy, so people won't be feeling claustrophobic in the cabin, I can say that, and people will be really comfortable, like three people will be comfortable, adults can be comfortable. There is a little bit of hump here, so three people like average size adults can adjust, but this will be much more comfortable for like two adults and a kid. Obviously if a kid is sitting here, you cannot use the armrest, and also there is a little bit of hump in the middle. So Suzuki is actually going to update this car, so don't worry for that, you will get to see the new car by next year. The headliner is good, but I won't say it's great like the XL6 headliner that you get to see. And if you haven't seen my XL6 review, then you can check out the pop-up button right there. The full in-depth review along with the driving impression of the XL6 is there. I can also see adjustable seat belts for the front passenger and driver. So that's everything on the rear interior. Let's now go to the front. Obviously there is light here which is not LED, so light is placed here, dome light. So that's everything on the rear interior. Let's now go to the front and show you in details about the front interior. So there is the dashboard and it actually looks nice, it doesn't look much dated, and I will show you how the material in the front feels. It's really very good compared to other cars in this segment and also other Maruti Suzuki cars, and I actually love this car, this S-Cross. I'm a big fan of this car, like how it looks, like this variant with that Pan Americana type front grille setup and all, like the AMG front grille setup. So let's now go to the front driver's side seat and show you more in details. Now coming to the front door, before going inside, I want to talk about the outside rear view mirror. Obviously body color mirror which are placed in the door itself, then there is the LED side indicator. That these mirrors or outside rear view mirror doesn't get the auto folding function. Yes, these are electrically folding because you have to press a button inside the door to fold these mirrors in and out. Then there is a physical key slot here for accessing the car if the battery goes down, and there is also a request button to the driver's side door. Obviously the co-driver's side door, I have already shown you that. This thing, this door guard here is actually accessory. Then the B pillar here gets a blacked out treatment which is actually matte finish and it looks good. No, this car doesn't get floating type designing or roof designing like the Baleno you see in Baleno and Swift. And again opening the door, the doors open wide enough. And the window in the front door are also big. There is also a quarter glass here which will help in reducing the blind spot area. Then again this panel here is hard plastic, and obviously this gets lateral type finishing. No, this is not soft touch. This thing here, like the rear door, is soft touch, and this portion here is also soft touch mirror which gets perforated laterite finishing. Then satin finishing done here, chrome door handle, lock and unlock button. This is for the adjusting the outside rear view mirror, and this button here is for electrically folding the in outside rear view mirror. I will show you that. This is the central lock button for locking and unlocking the car. Then auto one touch up down function is for the driver side window. No auto one touch function is for the other passenger side windows. Then bottle holder here, some spacing here for putting clothes and stuff. Now again you can see scuff plating here, Nexa, which is actually glowing. This actually glows, LED scuff plating. Then before going inside, I want to show you the pedal configuration and all. So there is a actual dead pedal there to the other side. Then also three pedals, clutch, brake and accelerator, obviously manual car. There is also ambient light there, white LED ambient light. No RGB light or such things in this car. Then there is a knob to pull the or open the hood of the car. Also there is a knob here for opening the fuel cap or fuel filler door of the car. Then the seat, front seat, driver side seat gets 6-way adjustability, so it also gets height adjustability, and these seats are really very wide and comfortable. And obviously laterite finishing is done, double stitching is done, as you can see perforation is also done to this seat here. I'll go inside and talk about the comfort level and all. Obviously there are more buttons here for fog light, then there is for the start stop system, ideal start stop system, because this car actually gets that mild hybrid system, and also there is the engine or ignition start stop button, and there is also a pocket type situation here where you can keep some coins and obviously keys. No, you cannot keep the phone here because it's not that deep. Then the AC vents here also get set in the finishing. So without talking much, let's now get inside and talk about the headroom and all those sorts of stuff. And before that, let me take the key and put it to the door sills here or the handle area here. Now let's close the door and put the seat a bit back and turn on the car, and then I will talk in details about the whole interior of the car. So this is the front dashboard design and all those sorts of stuff. Obviously analog meter, I actually love analog meter. I have no problem that this car doesn't get that full screen or digital instrument cluster. Turning on the blower a bit because it's too hot. Obviously the outside temperature in the MID is showing 25 degrees Celsius, but it's much hotter than that. And if you are watching the video till now, make sure you like the video and also subscribe to my channel so that you support me in that way. And anyway, moving forward, so first of all, talking about the front driver's seat comfort, the front seat is really very comfortable. It's very wide, so even 6 footers and above person can easily sit here. This car is actually a European spec car, and there the exact car is like little bit of things has been excluded for obviously cost-cutting reason, and the car is sold by Nexa in India. So the seats are actually made for like a person, or taking in consideration of the person from other countries. So they are wide, they are comfortable, obviously adjustable headrests are there. Obviously I cannot show you with one hand, and I'll try, but yeah, adjustable headrests are there, obviously you are getting it. And then again, look how wide the seats are. It's really very wide. Obviously cushioning is done here, perforation is done there, then double stitching obviously shown you. There is also height adjustment, so if I increase the height like this, I can have commanding view of the car. Then again, there is armrest here which can also be accessed. Yes, and there is also stitching done here. Obviously this also gets leather type finishing, which really feels comfortable to put your hands, and it also feels very nice to touch. And again, like, you can access it, but it doesn't get any sliding mechanism, also all those sorts of things. There is a deep section here where you can put your phone and all, because there is also a 12 volt socket here, and USB could have been given, but there is no USB. Also there is no light inside this storage area here, but storage area is there actually. Then there are two cup holders in the center console itself. This is the 5-speed manual gear, and the center console also gets some storage space around here to keep your phone and all those sorts of stuff, so you can keep it here. No, it doesn't get wireless phone charging and all those sorts of stuff, but there is a aux port here and also a USB port here, so you can charge it phone and keep your phone here. The center console also is fitted nicely, and it doesn't seems very flimsy and such, so it's fitted really nicely. The fit and finish in this car is really very good in the interior. Obviously this is the AC controls and all those sorts of stuff. Now coming to the sunshades, and all the sunshades are of really very nice quality. Obviously there is vanity mirror along with light placed here, and obviously this can be detached from here and put into this side, but not much of a use because large area here is left out. And again, to the co-driver side, the sunset also gets vanity mirror along with light placed here, because this is a top spec car. Obviously airbag warning and all sorts of things are given. Then there is a sunglass holder here. Obviously there is lights here, dome lights or map lights, whatever you say. Some mic situation and speaker situation are there in this area to the roof here. This could have been given LED, but yeah, it's the car is little bit outdated, but still LED could have been given. Then again, the inside rear view mirror gets auto dimming function. As you can see, auto is written here, so you can turn it on and off, so it gets auto dimming function, which is really very nice. So this is the interior or the dashboard design of the car. There are little bit of panel gaps in here, and you can see it, but normal people won't really consider all these sorts of things. So speakers or tweeter placed to the extreme corners of the dashboard. Then there is also a speaker situation here, which I believe is a subwoofer. Then AC vents there. Then AC vents here along with the 7-inch screen. I won't be talking much about the screen because this is the same screen you see in every sorts of Maruti Suzuki car, like from starting cars. Even the new Celerio will be getting this screen treatment, the 7-inch screen with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, obviously. So there is a satin finish surrounding here across the AC vents and also the screen here. And I really like how the screen is placed in the dashboard here. So in terms of design, the interior designing is done really very smartly. I love it. And this material here is actually a hard plastic, but it doesn't feel scratchy. Obviously, this material around this center portion here gets some rubberous type texture. Obviously, leather type finishing is given, but it feels like there is a rubber coating above here, which really feels good to touch, obviously. Then coming to the glove box here, the glove box is deep enough. There is also a light place in the glove box. Obviously, it gets cool functionality, but there is no actual cooling like vent in here. But if I can feel the air coming from this side here. And again, no hooks and all those things in this section in the center console here. Obviously, there is a satin type finishing here. No, the gear knob doesn't get any leather wrap treatment, and also no leather wrap treatment for the manual handbrake here. And there is the AC control. Obviously, auto AC is there. Then front defogger, rear defogger, off mode. There are different sorts of mode, like for the wind direction and all those sorts of stuff. And this is for the knob for the temperature control. I actually like how it's incorporated. It's really very simple to put your hands here and control the temperature and also the blower and all those sorts of thing while driving. Then there is a small LCD screen here to show you the modes and all those sorts of really very simple, not much gimmicks are done. Obviously, auto function is there in this AC. Now, talking more about safety features and all, the car gets dual front airbags, SRS airbag written there, also SRS airbag written in the steering wheel here. The front driver or the co-driver seats also get height adjustable seat belts, so you can see height adjustable seat belts are there. So lots of adjustment in this car, also for the co-driver seat, height adjustable seat belts are there. So yeah, obviously I cannot do it all those features with one hand. And again, you can see how the seats are. It's really very nice, very wide, comfortable seats. Obviously the co-driver seat doesn't get height adjustability or as such things. Then again, the screen, 7-inch touchscreen. I won't be telling much about the screen because you have seen this in all sorts of Maruti Suzuki car. Obviously this gets Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. So let's now check if the S-Cross actually gets adaptive guidelines for the rear parking camera or not. Let's start the car and check it out. So let me put the car into reverse gear here. So putting it in reverse gear, the view actually comes out. The resolution of the camera is also nice. Obviously the screen is actually, the resolution is nice in Maruti Suzuki cars. No, it doesn't get any adaptive guidelines for the reverse parking camera, so it's not there. But obviously there is a reverse parking sensor and all those sorts of things. The MID to the instrument cluster also shows the reverse parking sensor situation there. So that's it for the reverse parking situation for the screen here. Then coming to the steering wheel, really nice steering wheel. It's not that thick to hold, but it's actually leather wrap. Nice stitching is done here, you can see. Then Suzuki logo here, and again multifunction 3-spoke steering wheel. Satin finishing is given here. Obviously voice command situation and all those phone calling and all those things are there. Volume control is around here. So this section here is for the cruise control. No like adaptive cruise control or as such stuff in this variant. The upcoming variant may get that, like ADAS and all those sorts of stuff, because other car makers are also doing it. And the steering also gets tilt adjustability, as you can see here. And there is also telescopic adjustability. So tilt and telescopic adjustability along with driver height adjustable seat. So lots of adjustments are there in this car. This car also gets rain sensing wipers, which I forgot to tell you earlier, but looking at the controls I can see. So you can see rain sensing, auto rain sensing wiper, so you can actually set it like auto function and all. Obviously I will show you the windshield situation and all those sorts of stuff. So there are lots of spray on offer, and the wipers really work very nicely. And obviously rain sensing wipers is there, and also auto dimming inside your view mirror. So in terms of equipment, this car is really packed very nicely. Now coming to the light controls here, again you can see this car also gets that automatic headlight function. So here you can see automatic headlight control is there, and yeah, automatic rain sensing wipers. And these controls are actually very easily reached from the steering wheel, so you don't have to put your hand around or move your head while using the controls. And the stocks also feels fairly like nice. It doesn't feel cheap considering the price of the car. Now coming to the instrument console, this is actually a fairly simple analog instrument console along with a digital LCD MID in the middle there. So let me just turn on the car and show you about different tilted lights and all sorts of things. So Suzuki logo comes there. This is not actually colored, it's actually a negative LCD display. It's not colored LCD display like you have seen on the XL6 and all other cars. So this car, Maruti Suzuki, will be updating it soon enough, but don't expecting very soon, like around next year, July, August, or at that time it may be unveiled the new model. So moving forward to the instrument cluster, to the right side there is a big analog speedometer, obviously smart hybrid, all those sorts of things are written. Then different tilted lights are there. To the left side there is the analog speedometer, and obviously to the right side there is the analog fuel meter, and to the left side there is the analog heat meter. And in the middle here, the MID, it actually shows outside temperature, time, then instant fuel economy, trip A, trip B, and for controlling or going through different menus in the MID, you have to press the button here. So there is a knob here, so if I press it, you can see trip A, trip B, then total kilometer done and all those sorts of stuff. And this button here, actually to this right side, helps in increasing and decrease or going through different menus of the car. So it also helps in increasing and decreasing the brightness and all those sorts of things. So average speed, if I press this button, it's showing. Then again total idling start stop time, then again total fuel saved. And this is actually the regenerative braking, that or the mild hybrid tech, how it's working, how it's producing or generating current for the lithium ion battery. There is a small lithium ion battery for that regenerative braking and also giving that electric boost. So those sorts of things are there. No, this car doesn't get tire pressure monitoring system, traction control and as such things. So that's everything on the meter console and as such things. So let me now connect my phone to the system there and give you the sound quality, or show you the how the speakers in the S-Cross actually sounds. So let's do that. So I have already connected my phone to the screen here, the 7-inch touchscreen. Obviously this screen, like you have seen on the other Maruti Suzuki cars, doesn't get dedicated knob for controlling the volume and all those sorts of things. But yeah, steering mounted volume controls are there, so it's okay. But I hope Maruti Suzuki with their newer cars give a dedicated knob for controlling the volume for this screen. This screen is actually nice, like the sorts of features given in this screen, also the resolution, the touch response, the way it's tuned, it's really very nice. Now let me just give you the sound check of this car. So let's press the play button here. Obviously I can increase the volume from the steering mounted control here. So let's hear it. So obviously, personally, I feel the sound quality compared to other Maruti Suzuki cars is really very good. Obviously, there is also a subwoofer type situation placed here, and there is some sort of 3D surround type system is created. And yes, this system gets all those sorts of equalizer and all those sorts of adjustment for the sound setting and all. So the speaker quality is really very decent. I won't say very great, it's decent. The distortions are very less, and yeah, bass and treble quality is really very nice compared to other Maruti Suzuki cars that I have experienced. So overall, it's better than other cars. Obviously, this is the most premium car, like around 15 lakhs sold by a Maruti Suzuki. So yeah, obviously a good system, but I won't say it's excellent, because I've seen other cars, honestly, like other brand cars which comes with Harman system and all those sorts of things, those are much more better sounding to my ears than this. And that said, that was everything on the interior of the car. Let's now pop the hood and show you and tell you a little bit about the engine of this car, then I'll give you the drive impression and tell you how the S-Cross is out on the road, and you will actually know is it worth to buy or not. So let's do that. So coming towards the engine bay of this car, you can see the big hood. Obviously, large insulation area is done to this hood. There is also insulation to the firewall there, so that the engine doesn't go inside. Obviously, there is the hydraulic or the ABS motor there. No, this hood doesn't get any hydraulic struts. Hydraulic struts could have been given. This is obviously a premium car, but there is a simple stick here. And this is the 1.5 liter naturally aspirated petrol engine that gets obviously the mild hybrid tech. No, that's not the starter generator, that's actually the AC compressor. And talking about power figures, this engine in the S-Cross, just like the Brezza, makes 105 horsepower, 130 newton meters of torque. Obviously, this engine comes mated with both 5-speed manual gearbox and a 4-speed AMT, but I would suggest you to, if you are going for the S-Cross, go for the manual, because that will give you much driving pleasure. Obviously, there is not much plastic material like coverings and all those sorts of given. Really very clean. You can see the whole engine section here. The engine block is really very nicely visible, and I think there's the regenerative motor or starter generator there. And obviously, reinforcing is done in the pillar or the suspension pillar here. So this car ride quality is really very good. I will tell you in details how it feels when I give you the drive impression of the car. So that's everything on the interior and exterior details of the S-Cross. So without any further delay, let's just go for the drive impression now, and I will conclude the video after that. So right now, driving the Maruti Suzuki S-Cross. So talking about the overall driving impression of the Maruti Suzuki S-Cross, first of all, the visibility from the driver's seat is really very good. The driver's seat gets height adjustability, and also the steering wheel gets tilt and telescopic adjustment, so even shorter person can have commanding view from the driver's seat. The overall visibility of the car is good. The windows are wide. The A-pillars are a bit on the thicker side, but as the outside rearview mirrors are placed on the doors, and there is a small quarter glass, so the blind spot around the A-pillar area is less. And now talking about mirrors, both the outside rearview mirrors offers nice viewing angle. The inside rearview mirror also offer nice viewing angle, and it gets auto dimming function, so it has good anti-glare functionality. Now talking about the steering wheel, the steering is obviously leather wrapped. It feels nice to hold, but I think it's a bit on the thinner side. If it would have been a little bit on the thicker side, then personally I think it would be much better to hold the steering wheel. The controls in these cars are also very nicely placed. It can be easily reached from the steering wheel. Now talking about the engine is the 1.5 liter naturally aspirated petrol engine, and the car that I am driving is the manual variant. So the engine really pulls nicely, and it becomes live after 2000 rpm. Obviously, there are flat spots, but considering the price segment and the engine, it's okay. And there is the 12 volt mild hybrid tech, so there is a little bit of boost, and obviously Maruti Suzuki engines always feels peppy to drive, so the engine feels nice. The gear shifts are also sleek. The clutch feel is on the lighter side. Then coming to the brakes,
The S-Cross is offered with all wheel disc brakes, so the bite is good. Obviously it gets ABS and EBD as safety features, but there is no traction control or ESP as such in this car, as the car is a bit outdated. Yeah, obviously Maruti Suzuki will be updating the car very soon and it will get all those features, but don't expect the new car in India very soon. Now moving forward, the steering response of the S-Cross is really very good. The car really feels connected, the direction changes are quick, and as I've already shown you, the suspension towers are reinforced to each other, so the direction changes of this car is good. There is very less body roll that can be felt, and even the suspensions are tuned nicely. It's not on the softer side, neither it's on the stiffer side. It's well tuned, so people in this car will be very comfortable. Yeah, obviously the seats are cushioned very nicely and gets leather treatment, and the panels inside the car is also of high quality and it feels premium. There is very less vibration, and talking about vibrations, the NVH levels are well maintained. Tire noise cannot be heard very much, so overall people will be comfortable inside the car. The AC is really very good and it's powerful, but there is major missing of rear AC vents, but nonetheless the front AC vents can easily cool down the car fairly quickly. Talking about city driving condition, the S-Cross feels very compact from driver's point of view, and since the steering response is good, the car feels connected. Zipping through traffic will be really easy with this car, and the engine response or the power delivery of the engine is also good. Obviously there are flat spots around rev range, but that's pretty decent considering this car. And also it's fairly easy to take U-turns in the S-Cross as the turning radius is just 5.5 meters. So overall I think the S-Cross is one of the best offering from Maruti Suzuki under 15 lakh rupees if you consider every sort of thing like fit and finish, overall looks, driving dynamics, and even power delivery and comfort levels of the car. And if you're considering to buy the S-Cross, then you can really go for it over other Suzuki options like Vitara Brezza compact SUV. So if you are watching the video till now, make sure you like the video, also share this video with your friends and family so that they get it, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also press the bell notification icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video to this channel. So that's it for today. Bye.